Good morning, my dear legendary students. Welcome back to online.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, good morning, Imran. Good morning, Jabin.
Good morning, sir.
Mary. So, all of you, Madhuri, Anila, Pawani, Geeta. Good morning, all of you. So, today we are talking about.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Good morning, all of you. So, welcome back to online webinar classes. This is Krishna, HOD of Zoology. Today, we are going to in structured biology class. We already completed all biomolecules. Last biomolecules, that is DNA, is completed, and nucleic acids. Remaining nucleic acid, that is RNA structure and its functions. I think you already studied about this RNA structure and functions. So, what is RNA? What is RNA? RNA is nothing but, RNA is a polymer of, it is also ribonucleotides linked together 3' to 5'. Phosphodiester linkage. For example, see, we are seeing this is a 3' to 5'. So RNA which contains the polymer ribonucleotides. Already told you, what is ribonucleotides? Ribonucleotides means what? What ma? Nitrogen bases, sugar, and phosphorus. See, we are observing. See here, this is a sugar, this is a nitrogen bases, and this is a phosphorus. Phosphorus, sugar, nitrogen bases. This is what ma? Nucleotides. What is ribonucleotide means? The nucleotide which contains ribosugar. The nucleotide which contains what ma? Ribosugar. So here. Many. So RNA is a polymer of ribonucleotide. That means which contains many ribonucleotides. See 1, 2, 3, 4 like that, which is having so many ribonucleotides are there, which are arranged, linked together by 3' to 5', and with linked with the phosphodiester bond. But ma, phosphodiester bond is there. So that is a very important thing. This is the 3' and 5'. And see, we are observing, see here, RNA versus DNA. RNA versus DNA is there. For example, okay, so in DNA, what is there? DNA, already told you. DNA also which contains polynucleotides are there, polyribo, deoxyribonucleotides are there. What is that different? Okay, in the DNA, nucleotides are the same, phosphorus, sugar, nitrogen bases are there. Here also RNA which contains ribonucleotides. Okay, what is the ma? Here phosphorus, ribosugar, and nitrogen bases are there. What is the main different? Okay, RNA sugar is called ribosugar. DNA sugar is called deoxyribosugar. That is very important. That is very important thing. I remembering one thing. Okay, that is one of the different. Okay, see, and that one. And DNA which contains nitrogen bases are there, purines and pyrimidines. RNA which contains purine pyrimidines are there. But what is the difference here? See, for example, the DNA, what are the nitrogen bases? Thymine, adenine, guanine, cytosine is there. Okay, so here also same in RNA, cytosine, guanine, adenine, and uracil is there. That means what ma? Here, the DNA, which is contains what about thymine? In RNA, thymine is replaced by uracil. Simple, that is one of the different. But that is a different of same ribonucleotides and deoxyribonucleotides. So, for example, RNA which is a ribonucleic acid, DNA which is contains the deoxyribonucleic acids. That means what ma? RNA which contains ribosugar, DNA which contains what? Deoxyribosugar. That is one different. Okay. Second different, RNA is a single stranded structure. RNA is what? Single stranded structure we are observing. See, single stranded structure. And DNA, what is ma? DNA which is a double stranded structure. So, very important. The DNA, what na? Nitrogen bases, thymine, uracil, guanine, other mean guanine and cytosine is there. And whereas in RNA, what happened na? Thymine is replaced by uracil, same. The adenine and guanine and cytosine also same. That is main important. So that is the difference between RNA versus DNA. We are observing, see, okay, already told you. See here, the single stranded DNA in RNA which contains a single stranded RNA, DNA is a double stranded, okay? And RNA which contains ribose is the main sugar. DNA which contains the sugar, that is called deoxyribose sugar. Okay, na? Right? See, third point, pyrimidine component differ, thymine is never found. RNA does not contain thymine. But whereas in RNA, thymine replaced by the pyrimidine, that is called uracil is there in the RNA. DNA, thymine is always there, but uracil is never found. So in the DNA, uracil is not there, but whereas in RNA, thymine is not there. RNA, uracil is present. DNA, uracil is absent, thymine is present. That is the main difference. Okay. And remembering one thing. So the RNA being a stranded structure does not follow Chargaff rule. Does not follow Chargaff rule. What is Chargaff rule? Chargaff rule, okay, very important. Adenine is bind with thymine, is a double bind. Guanine bind with cytosine, that is a 1:1 ratio compulsory required. So that's why that is only present in DNA only, not RNA. That is what very important. It does follow Chargaff rule. The total purine content in a double stranded DNA is always equal to pyrimidine content. Already told you. So both two standards are there. That's why always adenines are that means pyrimidines are purines are bind with the pyrimidines equal ratio. That is because of two standards are there. Whereas in RNA single standard is there. That's why the Chargaff rule does not follow. This is the main important RNA and DNA. And next one, RNA can be easily destroyed. RNA can be easily destroyed. Remembering one thing, RNA can be easily destroyed by alkalines like cyclic diesters, mononucleotides. Okay, DNA resist alkyl action due to the absence of OH group at second carbon position. Because of OH group is absent in the DNA, that's why deoxyribose sugar, the sugar which contains does not contain OH group. That's why it is a easily it is not digest, it is not destroy with in the alkalic cyclic diesters. Okay, next one, the sixth point, the RNA is a relatively labile molecule. RNA is a relatively labile molecule undergo easy spontaneous degradation. So the RNA which is degradation by easily process, but DNA stable molecule. The spontaneous degradation is very slow, very too slow. The genetic information can be stored from years together without any change. Remembering one thing, the DNA is stable, remembering one thing. So years of years, for example, the DNA, if it is I would like to give you one example. Any knife to be, with help of the knife to murdered, the knife to be, kept at, that means, secreted like water, years of years. In the water, it should not die, it is not dissolve, it is not degradation. In alkalines, in temperature, whatever it may be. But the blood sample, which contains DNA, the DNA which is years of years to be very safe and secure because of it is a very stable molecule. That's why the DNA should not degrade. That is what very important. That's why the DNA which is helpful for the identification of the murder, identification of the parents, identification of the genetical material, identification of the any other extensive species also we are observing by using of sample. Yeah, that means air sample, fecal sample, whatever it means. Because of which is a DNA is a soluble, that means stable molecule. That is what very important. And the RNA, mainly cytoplasmic, the RNA which is present in the cytoplasmic, but also present in a nucleus. Actually, the RNA which is present in the, where ma? It is present in the cytoplasm, that is cytoplasmic the RNA, but also present in the nucleus also. Okay, the in the nucleus which is responsible for transcription and smaller nuclear RNA also there. Mainly found in nucleus. The DNA which is found in the ma? Compulsory present is found in the nucleus, and sometimes which is present in the extranuclear DNA is found, like which is present in the mitochondria. Mitochondrial DNA is present, and plasmids also which contains the DNA is there. Actually, mainly the DNA which is present present in where ma? Which is found in the nucleus. That's why it's called a nucleic acid. But whereas in animal cell and plant cell, okay, whereas in bacteria, it is found in DNA material found in mitochondria, okay, and plasma also. Sometimes in plants, chloroplast which contains DNA also. This is what very clear. Okay, next one, the base content varies. The base content varies from 100 to 5000 bases are there. The size is variable. Whereas in DNA, millions of base pairs are there. Depending upon the organism. That is what very important. Okay, so this is very important. And next one. So there are different type of DNAs or RNAs are there. Already told you, you know very well, mRNA, rRNA, tRNA, and snRNA, siRNA, miRNA, and hnRNA. These RNAs are performed different in specific functions. And different RNAs are there, mainly rRNA, tRNA, mRNAs are there. So this is, again, subtypes are there. So in different, which these RNAs are, which are function for the different function. So DNA is always one type of and perform the functions of storage and transfer of the genetic information. Of course, different forms are there in the DNA. No variable physiological forms of RNA are found. The different types of RNA do not change their forms. But the DNA, there are variable forms of DNA, A to E, DNA A, DNA B, DNA C, DNA D, DNA E, and Z also there. Okay, so and these are the A to E and Z also. Z also already told you, left double stranded DNA is there. Okay, now this is what a very important thing. Okay. So, and RNA is synthesized from, DNA. It cannot be formed DNA. Okay, right. RNA is synthesized from DNA. Remember one thing. RNA is synthesized from DNA. RNA should be formed from the DNA. But from RNA to DNA should not form. That is what very important. Except by the action of the reverse transcription, it can be duplicate. So, whereas different, that means, Murine leukemia virus, reverse transcription takes place. Whereas COVID-19 also, which is a reverse transcription takes place. Okay, so actually remember one thing, the RNA should be formed from the DNA. But whereas in, COVID-19, Murine leukemia virus, this type of viruses, what happened? So they can produces reverse transcription from RNA to RNA to DNA should be. That's it is harmful to human beings. It's very dangerous. Okay, now clear? So that is what very important. DNA can be formed. DNA replication. That is very, very important. The DNA should be formed by the DNA replication. It can also, by RNA. So, and from the DNA to RNA by transcription. central dogma of molecular biology. I already told you, from DNA to RNA should be formed by the transcription. DNA to RNA should be formed by the transcription. That is called what? Generally, the DNA should be formed by DNA replication. Okay, so whereas RNA should be formed by transcription. Okay, that is what very important. But RNA to DNA should not form. But some cases in viruses, brain leukemia virus, COVID-19 viruses. Okay, na? So what happened, ma'am? The RNA should produces DNA. That's why it is effect to human beings. Simply, the virus which is contains RNA reverse transcription, that virus to be transformed into reverse transcribed into DNA. It should be look like as a animal, human cell, human being cell. That is to cause to all to throughout the body, especially for lungs, throat, okay, kidneys, and etc. and circulatory system. And next, many copies of RNA are present in each of the cell. The particular copies of the RNAs which are present in each cell, a single copy of DNA is present in the per cell. Each cell which contains one type of DNA only, but many RNAs are present in the per cell. This is what important. Okay. Next, let us go to types of RNA. Okay, mainly in all prokaryotes and eukaryotes, in all prokaryotes and eukaryotes, mainly the main class of RNAs are there, RNA molecules are there. That is messenger RNA, that means mRNA, and transfer RNA, that is tRNA, and ribosomal RNA, that is rRNA. How many types? Three types are there. What are those? mRNA, tRNA, rRNA. Okay. M nothing but messenger RNA, T nothing but transfer RNA, R nothing but ribosomal RNA. Okay, na? So there are some molecular types are there. The small nuclear RNA, that means snRNA, micro, that means MIA, that means micro RNA, which is very minute structure, and small interfering RNA, that means SI, HN, that means heterogeneous nuclear RNA is there. So these are the different RNAs are there. SI means what? SN means small nuclear RNA, MIA means micro RNA, SN nothing but small interfering RNA, HN nothing but heterogeneous RNAs are there. These are the types of RNA. So now let us move to messenger RNA, mRNA. So this mRNA nothing but messenger RNA. Messenger RNA. So this is very important. So it comprises, see here, a cytoplasm. In the cytoplasm, mRNA is present. Is it clear? See, this mRNA should be formed from the DNA. The mRNA should be formed from the DNA by the transcription. Okay. That is what very clear. And from mRNA to proteins are formed with help of the ribosomes. So how much percentage of this which is present in the cell? It comprises only 5% of the RNA. How much percentage, ma? In the cell which contains, how much comprise? Only 5% of the RNA. Most of the heterogeneous in size, that means HI, in the basic sequence, it is a most of the this mRNA, which is which type? Ma? Heterogeneous type. That means HI. Next one, all members of the class functions as a messengers carrying information in a gene to the protein synthesizing machinery. So, which is what happened? Ma? To carrying the messengers, it look like a message. To carry the message, to receive the message from DNA and send it to so proteins are looking like so many proteins are produced from the mRNA. Okay, that's why the mRNA is called protein synthesizing machinery. The mRNA is known as what? Protein synthesizing machinery. Okay, clear? Next one, the structural characters of mRNA. So the 5-terminal end is capped by 7-methyl guanosine triphosphate cap is there. So where single stranded RNA is there, mRNA, it is a which contains 5' to 3'. The 5' terminal end, which is capped by 7-methyl guanosine triphosphate cap is there. What is that? 7-methyl guanosine triphosphate cap is there. The cap is involved in the recognition of the mRNA by the translating machinery. The cap is involved in the recognition of the mRNA by the translating machinery. It is translating the information from mRNA to polypeptide like proteins by the translation. That's what is called a translating machinery. Okay. Please mute Madhuri. Madhuri, mute yourself, ma. And next one, but ma, it stabilizes mRNA by protecting it from 5' exonuclease. Okay, so it stabilizes mRNA by what ma, protecting the from 5' exonuclease also there. So next one, the 3', that means the 3' end of the most RNA having polymer of adenylate residues there. How much ma? Polymer of what ma? How many bundles bund? Polymer but so many. Adenylate residues are there. Nearly 20 to 250s are there. How much ma? 20 to 250s are there. That is adenylate residues are there. And that the tail prevents. The tail prevents the attack by 3' exonuclease are there. The tail prevents the attack by 3' exonuclease are there. That is what we need. Okay. And the histones interferons not contain a poly a tail. Okay. The histones interferons do not contain in the poly adenylate residues. That means in the 3', okay, there is no histones interferons. And both 5' and 3', both 5' and 3', end there are non-coding sequences. Non-coding sequences which are not translated. Though whereas an mRNA, tRNA, which contains the 5' 3', that is what ma? Non-coded, that means non-coding sequence genetic codes are there. They are not translated. They are not translating. They are not translating like AUG, like UAA, UAG, UGA. So like that, these are called non-sensing codons are there. I think you already studied in genetic codes. Next, the intervening region between the non-coding sequences present between the 5' and 3', and is called a coding region. So the intervening region between non-coding sequences present between 5' to 3'. So that is called a coding region. Except non-coding region, that is the remaining one is called what ma? Remaining one is called what ma? Coding region. So this region encodes for the synthesis of proteins. Okay. For example, this is a 3', this is a 5'. So this between the non-coding sequences, so here coding sequences are there. So that region is called coding region. The coding region to encodes for the synthesis of the protein. Synthesis of a protein. Protein synthesis takes place with the help of the ribosomes by the translation. Okay, that is what very important. Okay, see here we are observing the structural characteristics of mRNA. So this is the cap 5' and 3'. This is 5' and 3', which is called non-sensing codes are there. 3' poly A is there, and this is the eukaryotic mRNA molecule which contains. So this is the coding sequences. Coding sequences are there. Okay, so this is a leader, this is a trailer is there. These are sequences are there, Okay. Here, what happened, ma? Stopping codons are there. That is non-sensing codons are there. NCS. 5' cap and 5' cap tell important stability to mRNA by protecting from specific exonucleases. Okay, now these caps are to protect from a specific exonucleases. Okay. Next, the mRNA molecules are formed with help of a DNA template during the process of transcription, already told at the beginning. How to form of mRNA? The mRNA production, this is a DNA, this is mRNA. It is to be formed by the transcription. By the transcription, that is one very important. See, mRNA molecule are formed with help of DNA template during the process of transcription. Okay. The sequence of the nucleotides in mRNA is complementary to the sequence of nucleotides on template DNA. Okay, this is what very important. The sequence of the nucleotides in mRNA, which is complementary. For example, this mRNA is complementary to the sequence of the nucleotides on the template DNA. Okay, now template DNA. Okay, the template DNA with help of the mRNA to be formed by using of mRNA to the form of mRNA, so that is a complementary to template of that DNA. The sequence carried on mRNA is read in the form of codons. Okay, whatever the messages to received by the mRNA, so that should be that message to be coding encodes on the codons. Like a sequence are there. A codon is made up of 3 nucleotides. Okay, how many ma? One codon. How to form of codon? The codon which is made up of 3 nucleotides are there. 3 nucleotides are there, remembering one thing. So the mRNA is formed after processing of heterogeneous nuclear RNA. mRNA is formed after processing of the heterogeneous nuclear RNA. So this is a very important thing. Next, what an hRNA? Heterogeneous nuclear RNA. See, in mammalian nuclei, HN, that means heterogeneous nuclear RNA is the immediate product of gene transcription. Heterogeneous nuclear RNA is a immediate product of gene transcription. The nuclear product is heterogeneous in size, variable, is very large in different species. Okay, the molecular weight may be more than 10^7 Daltons, while the molecular weight of mRNA is less than 2×10^6. Okay, so that is a different in there. 75% of hRNA is degraded in the nucleus. Okay, 75% of the hRNA, that means heterogeneous nuclear RNA, which is degraded. Only 25% of hRNA processed into mature mRNA. Okay, that is what very important. See, we are observing heterogeneous RNA to form of a mature RNA. How? For example, OVA albumin is processing DNA genome. For the DNA genome to be form of transcription, to be form of primary RNA, it is transcripted to be formed. Okay, right? From the primary RNA to an addition 5' and that means an addition of poly A in the tail region, poly A is there, 3' region, and then the 5' region cap is there. Okay, removal of these introns and the splicing. Okay, introns are between the chain which is introns are there. The group of nucleotides is called introns. Removal of introns, two introns in the splicing, the form of mature mRNA is there. Okay, so the from the heterogeneous RNA to be form of whatever na mature RNA. See here we are observing nearly 725%. That means 75% of the mRNA heterogeneous RNA to be degrade into cytoplasm, and only 25% of the mature RNA should be formed. Mature mRNA is formed from primary transcript by capping, tailing, splicing, and basic modification. This is what very important. So many times asked the question in NEET level. But ma, mature mRNA is formed from primary transcription by capping, primary transcript by capping process, tailing process, and splicing process, and the base modification is there. Okay, this is a mRNA. Okay, so today we are discussed what is a RNA, okay, how to form of RNA, what type of RNA is, okay, and complete information already given about the mRNA. Okay, tomorrow we'll discussing about the tRNA and rRNA and what is the functions of tRNA, rRNA. Okay, now we'll discuss it. Today the session is structural biology session is completed. Thank you very much. We'll meet exactly 9 o'clock for the immunology class. Thank you very much. This is Krishna, HOD of Zoology, signing out.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.